Well, I haven't made a video in quite a while. I've been out of town for a while, and I've been busy. As you can see, I'm tired of paddle oaring. It's starting to bother my left shoulder. I kind of messed my shoulder up years ago with a 24-foot extension ladder, and decided put a trolling motor on here. You can see the head of this motor is not on there. It's just the two wires. The other two wires that go to the shunt or coils. Whichever way this one's done, you don't need. I'm using a pulse width modulator. This item right here, I got a little box I'm going to be installing it in. As a speed control, forward and reverse and off switch, and a little meter tells you what percentage of the battery you're using, the power you're using. And the reason for that is, where did I put the head? The original head, right here. This had, 5 speeds forward, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 2 reverse. But all that's doing, different positions on there, all they do is run through a shunt, which coils, different coils, resistance, just adding resistance at different amounts to give you different motor speeds, and that causes you to use you're using your battery power, but you're wasting power to shunt this, to slow it down, where a pulse width modulator doesn't do that. So you give you longer use of your battery. I'm not totally, I should probably be more like this right now, you know, great on electronics, but from what I'm read, and this is how it's done. So, have the battery installed. If that battery doesn't last long enough, it should. No more than I'll be using it, no more power. I'll double the size or parallel two of those together. Didn't want real big heavy batteries too. Would like a lithium, ion lithium battery, but costs as much as the kayak. And also, for steering, turnbuckle, pipe clamp on, cables run up to the foot pedals. These foot pedals used to have a locking mechanism so that you could, they were adjustable, and that's for to rest your feet when you're using the oar or the paddle, if it's a double paddle, oar paddle, or whatever you call it. So took those off, run this cable up underneath, and just simply clamp them up there. You push on one. See how the other one moves? You push over here. And what does that do? Turns the motor. I didn't invent this. YouTube. I love YouTube. People have ideas and then they show them. So, that's what we'll steer with. We'll have the pulse width modulator to adjust our speed and forward and reverse and off when we don't need it. Keeps my hands more free for fishing. That was the other thing too, when I was out there fishing, if there's no wind or no current or anything moving there, which isn't all that often, it's not that bad. You kind of can stay in position, but usually I'd have this here, big paddle or this thing laying across my lap resting there. And I'd have to use it once in a while to readjust my positioning, and it was getting hard trying to balance that, and then you gotta pull fishing poles and you're trying to do that, and then you gotta try to maneuver. You got the fishing pole. You got to lay it back. And you can't just constantly fish. But this trolling motor, you know, steer with my feet, and I can just reach on real quick, get a little speed, forward, reverse, whatever I want. But I can continue to fish. I also made my own mounting bracket. And because it, you know, it was like $100 or over $100 to mount one on the side. I didn't want it on the side. I mean, you can mount it on the side and use the original controller and tune, but then you got to offset, and then it was back to the same thing. I got to, well, it wouldn't be as much, but I just wanted to do it this way. I wanted it centered on the stern. Now, this rope and this rope, I had to come up with a way, or I wanted a way, so that I can lift this if I get into some real shallow water. I'm going to set this down. Hopefully, you can see how this works. Now it works, this goes up there, you can see. When I pull this, this mechanism unlocks it, and then I pull this, and I can tilt it. Then I let go, and boom. I'm going to go back down, weave the tension, pull the lock, boom, lock back in. Cute, huh? It doesn't look pretty. This had to have this, when I pull this rope, move this mechanism down, but as it tilts forward, this has to rotate with it. That's why, without going, I just used stuff I had. Instead, I could have gone and bought some parts, different type joints and stuff to make this work, but it works. And that's where we got. The old kayak is coming along. Pretty good modification. So all this still left me room where I can put a cooler when I want, if I wanted, but I can put my dolly wheels on there. There's some couple lakes I'm going to go to that don't have a boat ramp. So I'm going to have to put the dolly on and drag the boat down there, which isn't, with that thing, it balances out pretty good. Not that hard to do. And that's what I did this video for, pretty short, just to show things we've been doing, that I've been doing. Pack the box here, camera mount, and my other camera mount that you guys have seen high behind me. I never showed what I did, but it's an old golf stick into a piece of, I think it was an old vacuum pipe. It comes out real easy, this little piece of TV, so it fits that fishing rod holder. There you go. Ready to go. This cable will run, I'll be putting quick disconnects on for these two. This runs up to the pulse width modulator, and then the battery. Other side will go to pulse width modulator, which will be, have a 30 amp fuse and another quick disconnect. So that's what we got going. And I'll post this video sometime tomorrow. That's my kayak setup. Thanks for watching.